into my room. See, you're gonna watch Godzilla vs. Megalon with me. Wait a minute. What are you doing in my room? Documentary? Why would I make a document? Oh. Yeah, you got me there. How am I gonna start this?
Hi, my name is Evan Martin, and I was born in Phoenix, Arizona, September 18th, 2003. I have lived there until I turned 10 months old a year later, 2004, where my mom got a job at Houston, Texas. But then my family moved again when I was 5 years old in 2010, that my parents both lost their jobs. Luckily, my mom found a job in Tucson, Arizona, where she was born. And so, I've been living here and growing here ever since. Living in Tucson, Arizona made me into the person that I am today. Whether it's discovering my talents, like performing in my after school program, mostly singing and dancing, or meeting some great people that I'm friends with, as well as being in a great school and environment. And now I'm here making this documentary. Can you believe that? That's insane. Insane. Ever since I was a kid, my number one interest is always Godzilla. I just remember that exact day I got introduced to the King of Monsters himself. Like a good portion of fans, my love for Godzilla started out on my craving for dinosaurs. When I was like a toddler, I freaking loved dinosaurs. When I was like 4 or 5, I like scrolled through YouTube for like hours watching countless dinosaur animations or toy documentaries. People would just take their dinosaur toys outside and start making their Walking with Dinosaurs-esque documentary with them. And those were like the best videos I've ever seen. I just remembered seeing some of them, like if not like a lot of them. But there was this one video, which is called The Birth of Godzilla. And to me, I thought it was just gonna be like another dinosaur video, but no, that video like changed my life. It started out as like at some island, and there was this like T-Rex, and this tank came up, and not only shot that thing, but freaking turned into like Godzilla. And as soon as he like turned to the camera, he shot his atomic breath at it. And I was like, whoa, what is this guy? And then ever since then, I've been watching lots of Godzilla videos. And my interest in Godzilla still reaches on till this day, which ever since then, I've been looking through numerous related monster movies like Ultraman, Gamera, King Kong, and very much recently, I have been watching like lots of movies and shows that I have like never watched when I was a kid, like Matango, Atragon, Ultra Q, War of the Gargantuas, any movie that I've like never seen, I want to get my hands on them. And also, I've been meeting people who have like the same exact interests as me. The kaiju genre is just so interesting. Godzilla not only is like my biggest interest, it also, however, really inspired me to like do things. Ever since I was a kid, I loved to draw. Like, I drew animals, I drew dinosaurs, I even drew Godzilla himself. I just drew whatever I can think about. And ever since then on, I loved doing it. But one thing Godzilla, like, inspired me to do things is filmmaking. Just like how I've watched those dinosaur videos, I've watched Godzilla videos. I've seen Godzilla animations, I've seen Godzilla fan films, I've seen, like, tons of videos. And I remember those exact videos that I saw when I was a kid, and they've like inspired me to do things like claymation and stop motion. And those videos were like a huge inspiration for me to like make a YouTube channel, which I didn't do so until like 2017. And so far it has like 4,000 subscribers. Can you believe that? That's very insane. For my other talents, however, I really enjoy performing. I love being on stage, being the big picture in front of like thousands of people or hundreds or so or less. I love being an entertainer. And at school, I love doing my theater class and my choir class. I enjoy acting and I enjoy singing and I enjoy seeing the people that I made friends with. It just feels like a partial family to me and I love that. It just sort of makes me feel like home.
So, tell me about yourself.
My name is Lupita Martin, and I'm a mom since 2003.
My name is Marley, and I'm an art student at Florida.
I'm Tor. I go by they, them pronouns.
I'm 16, and I'm a junior at Florida High School.
My name is Thomas Martin. I come from a great family, two wonderful parents, two sisters, two older sisters. I was born in upstate New York, the capital of Albany. Currently live in upstate New York. I'm a proud father of two wonderful, beautiful children. I have a son 18 and daughter that's 9. That's a little bit about me.
My name is Christopher Pankratz, and I am the theater teacher at Flooring Walls High School.
Hello, I'm Kira. I'm a digital artist and filmmaker.
My name is Jenny Campman. I teach choir at Flowing Wells High School, and I'm a choir teacher.
My name is Jen. I like planting, gardening, I like painting, and I sing.
My name is Ethan Ashmore. I'm a singer, an actor, a writer, as well as a trombonist. I dabble in piano, but let's not talk about that. I really like to create things, and I love to sing. Music is something that really impacts my life, and it defines who I am, so that is who I am.
What are your talents or other surprising facts about you?
My talents would have to be my art and my creativity. Surprising things are that
I'm currently in theater at my high school and in orchestra at my high school, and I've been playing violin for almost 9 years. I also play the guitar, piano, and ukulele. So I really like music, and I like making art and painting and stuff.
I can ride a unicycle. I haven't ridden one in many years, but I don't think I forget how. I love air hockey. I very rarely get to play air hockey. I don't have an air hockey table. And it's not always easy to find a place that does. On a regulation size air hockey table, I would say I'm more than an amateur. I can play very well when I put my mind to it and focus.
One of my talents that I'm kind of proud of is my ability to kind of problem solve and make things work. In theater, we're often on a budget or lots of constraints, so we're putting things together. So I really like working with students with putting things how they need to be to get a show done. And I'd say that's one of my talents, is that I'm pretty flexible and a good problem solver. I also like to paint and do all the artistic parts of theater and directing.
I like frogs, lizards, and birds. I also draw them sometimes.
Well, I'm a musician primarily, so singing is a talent that I have, and it's a skill that I've worked a lot at. I also am an instrumentalist. I've been playing violin since I was a little kid, and I've also been a drummer since I was a little kid. Some people find that surprising about me, that I play the drum set, so it's something that I'm really proud of.
I guess one of my hidden talents, it's weird, but nobody that I know can do it. I can pop my lips. I don't know anybody who can do it.
What made you into the person you are today?
You've made me a very patient person. I've never been patient in my life, and you have things that I'm not patient. But you've made me more patient than I had been in the past.
Allowing myself to be whoever I am, and not giving anyone patience, and not being influenced just for the sake of me. I got to be who I wanted to be at a young age.
Definitely having a son like you contributed to it. You're just a wonderful young man, and he day you were born, just everything that you brought into my life, everything you do, all the creative art and stuff, the videos, the sculpting of clay monsters, Godzilla monsters, animals, everything. So having a son like you contributed immensely into the person I am. It gave me a lot more meaning, I guess, in life also.
The ignorance of my parents. You see, when I was young, I always asked my parents to draw something, so when they stopped doing that, I was like, fine, I'll do it myself. My artist awakening happened at the age of 9. When my city was going through a war conflict. And me seeing all those horrors, I just started in illustrating it. Since then I draw stuff and write tragic stories.
It's a big question. It's hard to answer briefly, but I would say that the two biggest things that make me who I am are my family and my faith.
I'd have to say it's my close friend group. I've been with them since third grade. It started with just me and Harley Washburn, and then it grew. It grew into something crazy. And without those people, I'm telling you right now, I wouldn't be like this nice kid. I wouldn't be a singer. I wouldn't be doing the things I do. Like, I probably wouldn't even be taking risks. I would probably be that kid in the back of the class that nobody talked to, or if you did talk to me, I would mess around. It wouldn't be nice. High school would probably be worse. I probably would have dropped out. Who knows? But yeah, that's it. My friend group. I owe them so much. They are so amazing.
What are your hopes and dreams for the future?
I hope to get our backyard done. I hope you get everything that you deserve, that you work hard for. That's it. I hope you're happy.
My hopes and dreams are to become a famous tattoo artist after school. I'm really into tattooing and I'm pretty good at it. So hopefully I'll be able to become someone in the future.
Have more and spend more time with my kids, with you and with your sister as much as possible. I always hope that and dream that I'll be able to do more, travel more, and do different things with you. I know you're very busy. You're a very busy young man. But I think we'll have time in the future to do a lot more things and have more great experiences together, adventures or whatever. Well, I guess those remain to be my hopes, my dreams.
Move to the bigger city and be happy with a person who cares about me.
I honestly say this to my students all the time, but I have my dream job. I do my dream job every day, getting to teach choir here. So I'm hoping to continue doing that for a long time. I'm hoping to have a family in the next couple of years. I just got married a couple of years ago, so we're thinking about maybe having a baby in not too long.
To have a lot of money, to be successful, to not financially struggle as much as my family did.
It shifts, and you're going to hear that from a lot of people. It always changes. You never really know until it happens. But for me, I just want to be out there. I want to be in the entertainment industry, whether that's writing a story that will end up in a movie or a video game, whether that's acting, singing on stage, whatever it is. It's just, I want to show myself and put out that spectacle that I can throw. You know, I want people to see me for who I am and see what I can do. And no matter how long that lasts, I might get my spotlight for like 1 year. And then, who knows? They might say, we don't like your acting anymore. Get off stage. And it doesn't happen. I want to try. I want to see if I can get that dream. If I can at least say that I went out trying, then I'll be happy working that very tedious office job. Because at least I tried to get my dream. I didn't just give up.
So I have two pictures. Both of them I really like very much. Which one goes the hardest?
The bottom one. It goes hard.
I like the artist drawing of him in the pants a lot. I think it's funny. I think it's charismatic.
I like the hip-hop style SpongeBob. Kind of reminded me of a St. Patrick's Day type of SpongeBob. He had his green hat on. He has, you know, jewelry. He has money. He's kind of like the cool... SpongeBob's cool anyway without trying. He's cool in his own way. But that particular picture of SpongeBob, he was completely swagging. He was dabbing and dripping. He had cash. He had watches. He was blinging. And it was a cool look for SpongeBob to have. You know, he definitely was a cool look. That picture I liked. The other one I liked as well, but I like the swag cool. SpongeBob.
I definitely like the second one. He is very square in the second one. And I like his expression.
The first one, it's quite epic.
I like the first one a lot. I don't know if I could explain why, but I just really like SpongeBob's attitude in that picture.
Definitely Pimp Bob. Vote Pimp Bob.
I have a soft spot for the top one, you know, like, you know that, like, it reminds me of that meme with the endings. It's like ending one, like SpongeBob lives, ending two, you know, that gangster SpongeBob, love him, top picture.
None of them, zero. They both suck.
You have to choose one.
They suck, both of them.
So you have to choose one more.
The one that's long. With the brown pants.
Is there anything else that you wanted to say before this interview ends?
I'm so very proud of you. I'm gonna start crying again, but I'm super proud of you, Evan. You don't know how much I am very proud of you. And I love you with all my heart. And I hope you're happy for the rest of your life. And it looks like Cindy's gonna make out with you.
If I were to give advice to anyone, especially kids in my age group, if you need to rest, rest. Keep doing something because you feel like you have to. If your body's done, if your brain's done, take a break. It's okay.
Continue doing what you're doing. Follow the dreams that you have. Love what you're doing. Making time for the things that you love and enjoy. Life goes fast, and so those things are important. That's about it. And always remember, even when I'm not here someday, or your mom's not here, we'll always be with you. Good luck, son. I love you.
I'm really proud of you, Evan. I think you're going to do great in life. Always remember to stay humble, be nice to people, be good to work with, and you will be very successful in whatever you do.
The life advice that I would say is to pursue your dreams and to do what you're passionate about. When I was in high school, I didn't know making a career as a musician would be a viable, you know, future for me. And I'm so glad that I did. And I would give that advice to anybody. Whatever you're passionate about, whatever fills you with joy, that's what you should do in life.
Spaghetti. Awesome.
I like frogs.
Let me out of this meat prison.
Well, I guess that's about everything you have to know about me. I mean, I would love to talk more about myself, but I don't want to make this documentary any longer. But all I can say is this. My life is amazing, and it gets better and better every year. Have a good day, evening, night, or whenever you're watching this. But for me, it's good night. So, I hope you enjoyed everything of what I showed, and have a good rest of your time.
Sorry. Marley told me to take a behind the scenes photo.
I'm trying not to cry.
What made you into the person you are today?
Oh, jeez.
What are your hopes and dreams for the future?
Also, an experience would have to be...
What are one... stuff you learned or...
Hi,
Dad. Oh, hi, Miss Brown.
This is the filmed interview.
Oh, hey, Pat Snow's over here.
You're gonna have a lot of editing to do. Okay, ask a question again.
Okay. All that stuff, but my friend group, we've been...
You're still good, Miss Brown.
It's okay.